Hi and welcome to Hippo Brain. Here is where we have hippo-sized conversations with people with hippo-sized brains. Today's guest is one of my favorite planners. And really, really, a lot of what I've learned in marketing, I would have learned from this guy. He's an outstanding human being and an extremely clear thinker. He obviously, every time when you speak to him, he makes himself small. He says very simple things. I mean, you have to really go back. And many times when he's told so many things, you know, I've gone back. And 1 year, 2 years, 3 years ke baad, I've realized the gravity and the strength of what he's spoken. He is currently the head of planning at Ogilvy. And I think he's the most beautiful human being. I have said it. I'm saying it too much because, of course, I'm influenced a lot by him and his thinking. Prem, the head of planning at Ogilvy, let me start by asking you a provocative straight-on question. Mere hisab se planning in an agency today is a total waste because it has only two uses. One, during the pitch, I get to see the planner's face when he comes and makes some brilliant strategy and all of that. Second, when I'm really pissed with an agency and mere ko lagta hai, agency ko lagta hai ki ab to main client, I'm going to lose the client, let's get the planner. दो ही बार स्ट्रेटेजी का काम आता है, बाकी तो सब कुछ क्रिएटिव चलाता है और बेचारा अकाउंट सर्विसिंग आदमी भागता है. प्रेम,
ओके, सो नॉट वेरी फार फ्रॉम व्हेन आई जॉइंड Ogilvy Jamit, सो आई वाज अमंगस्ट, आई वाज द थर्ड और द फोर्थ प्लानर फॉर Ogilvy इंडिया. टुडे वी आर 65 पीपल. सो या वी द डिपार्टमेंट वाज, चलो जो बहुत मंथन करता है, यू नो, क्लाइंट्स हु आर हेविली इनटू इंटेलेक्चुअलाइजिंग, लेट्स थ्रो दिस फेलोज हु विल थ्रो सम इंग्लिश जार्गन्स एट देम, वाज परहैप्स व्हाई इट ऑल स्टार्टेड. बट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम आई थिंक इट्स इवॉल्व्ड फंडामेंटली टू होपफुली पीपल सी अस एडिंग सम वैल्यू. एंड लेट मी एक्सप्लेन व्हाट वी डू सो दैट मेनी पीपल मे नॉट नो व्हाट प्लानिंग इज, जस्ट टू एक्सप्लेन. So actually, there was only two functions in advertising, which was account management. People who managed the relationship got the business. And then there were creative people who did the creative on the business. That is all there was. And at that time, what used to happen is consumer understanding used to be third-party research. And they used to do the research and come back. But agencies felt we don't have any consumer feel. So it's like, imagine I have to create an ad for somewhere in UP and me sitting in South Bombay is talking some very esoteric South Bombay club kind of language, and we had no real feel for the work that we were creating and the people we were talking to. So essentially advertising was, planning was gotten to do that connection. In very simple terms, what we do on a day-to-day basis, and I try and tell this to my mother or anybody who says, "Tu karta kya hai?" Because ad jo TV mein aata hai, creative banda likhta hai, paisa koi aur leke aa raha hai, tu karta kya hai udhar baithe? So the simple.
Even thing, I have been trying to explain to my mom that.
Yeah. So the simple thing way to look at it is, what is the real marketing or communication problem that we are trying to solve? Is decided, which is a brief that we decide between the planner and the client. So if you say that I want to grow market share from X to Y percent, now it can come in 2-3 ways. I want people who buy chocolate once to buy 3 times is one way to do it. Or you say, no, people who are buying somebody else's chocolate should buy my chocolate is a second way to do it. Basically, 2-3 tarika hai na growth ka. Ya to kisi aur se churao, ya tum zyada consume karo. Now, but that decision is critical. Now, how do you decide? And this is done usually with large clients on the basis of numbers, what they call source of business. Where are we going to get business from? Now, this is the start point of what we call a communication brief, which the planner works closely with the client to decide. Because if you get this wrong, everything else goes wrong. Because the consumer audience, so I'll give you an example. So many years back, we were doing Red Label tea in Unilever. Now, for a long time, we tried to say Red Label at one point was a 35-40% market share brand. It had come down to 10-12% market share brand. And the client would say, "Yaar, we have to grow." And then we went and tried. And they said, lots of people have now gone to local brands like Suppert or Wagh Bakri or Vikram Number One or any of these brands. And if you go and talk to the consumer, they would tell you that, साहब आपका टी और रोटी में कोई फर्क नहीं है और आप 25 रुपया ज्यादा हो, मैं क्यों आऊं आपके पास. नाउ अभी ये प्रॉब्लम इफ यू से नो आई हैव टू गेट शेयर, करंटली सपोर्ट लेने वालों को रेड लेबल खरीदने गए तो उसको हम जाके इमोशनल, अरे चाय से प्यार मोहब्बत बढ़ता है, एबीसीडी बोलेगा तो वो बोलेगा तेल लेने का, तो वो गया। तो ये चक्कर हम लोग 3 साल घिसाया। सो इन दिस स्ट्रगल एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू बिकॉज दीज आर ऑल मिस्टेक्स, वेरी मीन आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ यूनिलीवर, ओगिल्वी, वेरी सीनियर मार्केटिंग प्रोफेशनल्स, राइट? नो, वी सेड नो, वी हैव टू गेट दिस फेलो। सो इट बिकेम, एंड नाउ वी आर लॉफ, देयर इज सम पीस ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग व्हिच इज टी में है फ्लेवोनॉइड जो हार्ट ब्लड सर्कुलेशन बढ़ाता है, सो बाकी चाय सिर्फ स्वाद है, ये टेस्ट और हेल्थ है, ठीक है? ये सर मैंने बनाया भाई। उसमें अनुपम खेर था, दादाजी आप क्यों पी रहे हो, नाउ व्हाई आर यू लाफिंग, अगर मैं आपके, बट लुक एट हाउ ब्लाइंड वी आर। इफ आई केम एंड टोल्ड यू जेमे ड्रिंक रेड लेबल बिकॉज इट इंक्रीजेस हार्ट सर्कुलेशन, तो बोलेगा चाय सर, चाय और हार्ट सर्कुलेशन, भाग जा। मैं भी बोलता था एज अ कॉमन मैन, बट आई डिडंट डू दैट। सो वी डिड दिस एडवर्टाइज, फाइनली वी केम टू द रियलाइजेशन, बॉस इससे कुछ होने वाला नहीं। देन वी वेंट एंड मेट सम कंज्यूमर्स हु सेड, हु एक्चुअली लाइक रेड लेबल, बट दे बाय इट ओनली 1 or 2 times आउट ऑफ द 12 टाइम्स अ ईयर, बिकॉज ऑफ या तो उनका बजट थोड़ा टाइट है तो लोकल ब्रांड ले लिया, पर उनको लगता है रेड लेबल अच्छा है। तो इफ आई नीड हिम टू बाय रेड लेबल from 2 to 4 times a year, I'll double market share na, without having to try to tell him ki isme flavonoid hai, for I just have to tell him bhai iska swad sabse acha hai, aur usko wo lagta hai. In advertising that is very top of mind and salient, which is why we did that Hindu Muslim ad. The brief was, let's make very famous advertising that glorifies the taste instead of going to health. So this is the first job we do, decide marketing objective kya hona chahiye, उसके हिसाब से कम्युनिकेशन ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या होना चाहिए। एडवर्टाइजिंग मोटा मोटी इतना ही है, ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है, हु कौन है, कंज्यूमर कौन है, नाउ इसमें बड़ा गोल है। नाउ सडनली आई हैव शिफ्टेड द हु टू रेड लेबल यूजर एंड नॉट अ सपोर्ट यूजर, नाउ एवरीथिंग इन द ब्रीफ चेंजेस बिकॉज देन व्हाट आई नीड टू से ऑल्सो चेंजेस। सिमिलरली विद माय फर्स्ट जॉब इन ओगिल्वी, द फर्स्ट कैंपेन आई डिड वर टाटा सफारी रिक्लेम योर लाइफ, माय फर्स्ट एड इन ओगिल्वी, the client brief was Tata Safari has more power, creative had done campaign. I went and met some consumers and they said the reason why I don't, okay, they said wo tabhi safari aur scorpio do gaadi tha, politician lal batti safed gaadi wo to anyway le lega, mera incremental sales have to come from urban people buying the safari for whatever the symbol that it is. When I went and spoke to consumer, the reason people were not buying safari had nothing to do with power or any of that, the reason had to do with practicality, BV, अरे किधर पार्क करेगा, इट्स अ बिट लाइक बुलेट, दिल कहता है सफारी ले, बट द रैशनल साइड इज सेइंग अरे यार ये सब छोड़ो, एक सेडान ले लो एंड ऑल दैट, बट देन व्हेन आई आस्क्ड हिम, तुझे लगता है कि व्हेन यू आर इन अ सफारी एंड व्हेन यू सी अ गाय इन अ प्लश सेडान इन अ कॉर्पोरेट, देन मोस्ट पीपल हु वांटेड अ सफारी वर ईदर बिजनेस एंटरप्रेन्योर, स्टार्टअप, फोटोग्राफर, दैट काइंड ऑफ पब्लिक, दे सेड आई मे बी लेस सक्सेसफुल देन दैट फेलो इन द सेडान, बट वो साला गुलाम है, उसका बॉस का हुजूरी, हाँ हुजूर डालना पड़ेगा, मैं अपना मर्जी का मालिक। सो नाउ इट हैड नथिंग टू डू विद इंजन पावर फलाना। सो देन आई वेंट एंड टोल्ड द क्रिएटिव, इफ यू वांट टू सेल टू अ कॉर्पोरेट गाय, पोक हिज हार्ट एंड मेक हिम फील दैट ही इज नॉट अ कॉर्पोरेट रैट, दैट ही कैन ब्रेक आउट एंड लिव हिज लाइफ, एंड वी डिड रिक्लेम योर लाइफ। नाउ दिस जस्ट टेल्स यू द शिफ्ट। सो व्हाट प्लानर्स डू आइडियली इज मार्केटिंग ऑब्जेक्टिव, कम्युनिकेशन ऑब्जेक्टिव, और कंज्यूमर को बदल दो।
So, Prem, just to interrupt, what you're really doing is going and having conversations with customers. That is the starting point.
Yes.
And yes, the feedback from them really is what you're distilling and then saying to the creative, this is why they are buying or not buying. And now how do we sort of either switch them or get new customers, yes, new consumers, whatever. Yes. That's the core. So it starts with the, what you said earlier, the research component.
Yes.
Which is conversations with customers.
Yes. And yes, absolutely, Rajesh. And one big difference that I like to tell people is most people meet consumers to find solutions. It's a better thing to meet consumers to understand the problem. People go searching for insight and advertising trigger. Often we don't know problem kya hai. And marketeers understand marketing problem, market share, growth, I need to sell more, I need to do this. They don't necessarily understand why is the consumer not buying. I'll give another example, like Pulsar. Definitely male, Ogilvy believed was an iconic line, which had advertising like, you know, dupatta leke steering ghumta tha, this whole, it's the male bike and all of that. It was the original advertising. When we went and did, when I went and met, and for 2-3 years it went on, but it was not growing as fast. And intuitively, the client used to tell us something's not working. We're not demonstrating the bike and all of that. So I went and met these consumers and they said, अब क्या साहब वो ये छोकरी वोकरी को इम्प्रेस करने का ना वो 18 साल बच्चे का गेम है उसके लिए अलग बाइक है. आई एम अ स्टड. फॉर मी माचोइज्म इज व्हाट आई कैन डू विद माय बाइक. इट्स नॉट अबाउट अट्रैक्टिंग समबडी एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. एंड देयर वाज वन ओल्ड एड व्हिच वी हैड डन बाय फ्लूक व्हिच वाज पल्सर 180 जब लॉन्च हुआ. ओनली अ पल्सर कैन बीट अ पल्सर. उसमें पहली बार वो व्हीली दिखाया था और एंडो और व्हीली तो वो दिखाया ना आपने वो है. नाउ दिस फेलो इज दिस गाय यू नो हु ड्राइव्स द पल्सर. वो बांद्रा से मीरा रोड जो 25 मिनट में मैं भगाएगा वो है पल्सर बंदा. वो सिग्नल में खड़ा होके बोलेगा व्हेन ही सीज अ बड़ा बाइक ना स्टॉप एट द सिग्नल से अगला सिग्नल रेस लगाएगा क्या. नाउ दैट इज हिज माइंडसेट. नाउ व्हेन सो वी शिफ्टेड टोटली फ्रॉम दिस डेफिनेटली मेल अट्रैक्टिंग द ऑपोजिट सेक्स स्टोरी लाइक एक्स to saying Pulsar is about your ability to feel the rush and do the stunting. So the bike moved to the whole stunt world on the basis of that, which Rajiv Bajaj now calls what he calls demonstrivity. It is creative demonstration of the bike's ability, very much like iPhone advertising. There is no other emotional layer and gas. Just show what the bike can do or the phone can do in all its glory. That's all you need. So yeah, these are some. So essentially Planner does that. Marketing problem, what? So if I tell people, what is the problem? Who's the consumer and what to do? The planner defines with the client. How to say it is largely done by the creative. Simply bole to ye planner.
To ye Prem, as usual, ekdam simple tune bol diya. And I, mere dimag mein ghus gaya. Lekin ek question hai. You know, most of the time, very simply you say, going in listening to consumers. And I have seen that it is not easy. See, because most planners, I maybe have intellectual arrogance on my side. I cannot handle most planners. It comes across shallow. It comes across weak. It comes across not rooted in what consumer. People often go and, like you rightly said, thinking about marketing solution kya hai, as opposed to uska dil kya bol raha hai. Now, how do you have 65 planners. I'm assuming sab tod phod hai. How do you get them? How do you work with them? How do you teach people ki Prem, you have a listening skill. How does that scale up?
Not easy, Jamit, honestly. And unfortunately or fortunately, see, in the West, most planning people come from the arts and the psychology kind of backgrounds. In India, maybe the next generation, maybe our generation all did that. Abhi sab ye MBA, FMBA, all that jazz. But to answer your question, it is a skill that comes with patience. You have to keep doing it again. Meaning the biggest problem I have today is to tell people to leave the computer screen and go meet people. That itself is a first level challenge. People think all research can be done by Googling. And often you miss the human side and the stories. I like to listen to stories, also line of questioning. I'll give you another story on Red Label when we did the Hindu-Muslim ad. We had decided we don't want to do this flavonoid health and all. We just wanted to say, taste kab important hai logon ko. So when we went, they said, sab guest aate hai na, tabhi swad, humko lagta hai, chalo achhe. And one lady said it so beautifully. She said, saab kuch log aate hai, jinsko actually humko nahi hai, we don't want them to come. To usko main pani pila deti hu. फिर कुछ लोग आते हैं उतना खास नहीं है पर वी हैव टू डू खातिरदारी तो आई डू सॉफ्ट ड्रिंक. फिर कुछ लोग आते हैं जिनके साथ ना मुझे वक्त बिताने का बहुत इच्छा होता है पर वही लोग को टाइम नहीं होता तो मैं स्टोव में चाय चढ़ाती हूँ. देन दैट लेडी विल कम्स बिकॉज चाय मेकिंग दैट कॉन्वर्जेशन हॉट बेवरेज सिप करते हुए वैसे 15-20 मिनट मिल गया. और वो स्वाद जो है दैट इज अ स्टोरी. देन वन गर्ल टोल्ड मी दिस स्टोरी व्हिच देन गॉट कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ स्क्रिप्ट दैट शी वाज अ महाराष्ट्रियन ब्राह्मण गर्ल आई थिंक हुज बेस्ट फ्रेंड वाज अ मुस्लिम एंड आई थिंक हर हाउसहोल्ड वाज अ लिटिल कंजर्वेटिव But she said, on Ramzan or Eid, I used to go to drink that kheer because I used to really love it. And then it just came. And this is the story, she said. She didn't give any other gyan, but it was a touching story. And I was thinking, like, food has the ability to cut across caste, class, religion, everything, right? Meaning everybody goes to everybody's house and we've all seen it and all of that. So I told the creative guys, one great magnifier of taste and food can be this bridging the divide. And that's how that Hindu-Muslim script on Red Label came. And the client is equally important, right? And there were other scripts. Now the client was, he in his mind was very clear, I want a famous ad. He wanted an ad that people will talk about. So he picked that script. But to your question, Jaimit, is it easy? No. What does it take? I think it takes a lot of empathy. You know, Jesse, some good qualitative researchers are people you can learn from. Then it is just practice. The most important thing is, I think, if you're a little less arrogant about what you think you know vis-a-vis what the consumer is saying, perhaps you will get there. Not easy. Meaning, I'm telling you the 4 or 5 examples that I've succeeded for the 25 where I have failed.
So, Prem, how do you decide whom to meet? Now, I'm assuming there are two types. One is the existing customer of the brand. So there you obviously want that person to buy more. So that is one. Second is, it's a switching problem in most cases, that they're using a competitor and you want to see why that person is not buying the brand and you want them to then switch. Now there's an ocean of customers out there. How do you decide ke isko jaake milna hai, usko jaake milna hai, or it doesn't matter? You just meet 20, 30 people.
No, it's a very important. So there is a...
Prem, how many also? Wo bhi answer karna.
So I'll tell you both. So let's say, Rajesh, you are my client. First, which is why I said the marketing objective is clear. So you suppose you are selling potato chips. You might say, you know what, Prem, I have looked at all my data. And one way to say is, and then we have to collectively agree that one way to grow is, I can grow if I get people who are buying Lays to buy me. That you may say. But you may say, nahi yaar, wo bahut alag khel hai, chhod do. मेरा डेटा एक और चीज दिखा था एंड विच रिजल्टेड इन अ वेरी फेमस कैंपेन कॉल्ड सैंडविच द इनसाइट दे केम टू वाज एंड दिस द मार्केटियर एंड द प्लानर डिसाइडेड आई हैव बीन लुकिंग एट माय डेटा विच इज नंबर्स योर क्वार्टरली सेल्स अक्रॉस मेनी पीरियड्स एंड दैट विल टेल यू सम पैटर्न इफ यू लुक एट इट केयरफुली विच दे कॉल शेयर लॉस और गेन लॉस एनालिसिस आई एम गेनिंग फ्रॉम एक्स ब्रांड लूसिंग फ्रॉम वाई ब्रांड और इट मे बी मोमेंट्स वेयर यू माइट से दैट यू नो आई नोटिस्ड दैट For example, in England on chips, they said everybody likes to eat chips with sandwich, but most people buy sandwich but don't buy chips. Now, this is data. Now, you go and say, okay, let me try and understand why people buy chips or don't buy chips. It may be as simple as I'm a sandwich, but jab main sandwich sochta hun, chips nahi sochta hun. That may be one kind of... So, the who to meet is decided by where you think the source of business is. If you feel it's going to come from users of other brands, I will usually go and meet the users to understand why they are not buying this. I will also meet my own consumers to understand why is this fellow keeping on buying. Then I'll see, okay, is this reason working for that consumer? That usually decides who you meet. And that's a very important thing. And in proper large organization, there is a research brief that goes out to a third party research, which lines out objective, who's the consumer we are meeting, is it small town, big town. Sometimes you also go to large, strong markets of a brand, weak markets of a brand. Like when we do Amazon now, the north and the south consumer are entirely different. Like when we used to do, you may remember we did this campaign called Chongpur Cheetah and all that. The South consumers said, what is this sensibility? Kya hai bhai ye Chongpur Cheetah and all of that. I don't relate to any of this. And the people said, yes, how hawa ji, theek hai, but tell me, why should I buy Amazon? Give me reason why. Return lega kya? Kitna EMI mein deta hai? So you need a lot more justification to push people into buying to e-commerce in a South Indian audience. So that also decides that. How many you do, Jaimit, I find it. The quantitative side is important if you want like you know to understand data, like okay, where am I losing share from, gaining share from, kidhar se aayega, for that you need large quant data. Or even to understand UNA studies like usage and attitude at a, like you, if you want to know at scale what are the differences in region, how many people are buying this in this way vis-a-vis another way, that you need quant. Otherwise, qual is good enough for the softer. Again, the what is quant is better, why qual is better, and why you can do. I've done as little as 10, if you are very clear. Sometimes you do 10, 15, 20 focus groups depending on the nature of the problem, like regional differences, things like that. That's broadly what research looks like.
And I've also seen my experience. FGDs are always nice, but your DIs, the in-depth interviews that you end up doing, sometimes are far more evocative and far more powerful, especially done if they are in their house, in their own setting, etc. And second, I always believe that I should do research myself and do depth interviews myself. And I think the best FGDs are where I have sat inside. And that body language, etc. So how do you do that? And Prem, you're the head of planning. Sub brands aake tere ko bolega, main Prem ka to clone nahi bana sakta hun. But this feel, etc. And a marketer who relies on the report of the qual versus going out and meeting. What is your stand on that?
Okay, so some of the best marketers, however senior, do research themselves. I have seen very, very senior people in large multinational companies or even Indian companies. Like if you look at Asian Paints, Unilever, some of the better marketeers, they may not do like 100 interviews, but they will go and meet consumers at least once a month. Even during these COVID times, I've seen very, very senior people. Like one of my tea clients recently told me, hey, Prem, I spoke to this consumer and I think it was a call like this, but he said, she said three things or mujhe, she said, ek cheez bola wo chai, taste ke bare mein, I think there is something there. And these are simple things, right? Like, haath mein dal ke she tastes to check ki taste acha hai ki nahi hai, no, is there something there in, while apna culture mein jhoota bhi hai, but it's a very Indian thing. And so she told him two things. I always check taste when it matters ki unko acha lage. She also told him, jab cup ke niche na, जितना रहता है उससे पता चलता है कि चाय उनको पसंद आया कि नहीं. Now this is a great advertising cue. Like if I build a story on a guy who or a woman who looks at the cup and is still seeming like she wants more, it's an automatic cue to say that she found the taste it tasty. रह गया तो मतलब उसको पसंद नहीं आया. Now good marketers definitely go meet consumer themselves. There is no substitute, honestly, to doing that. If you meet yourself, and the more time you spend in marketing and advertising, you are able to pick up more. Just because of, like in everything else, more experience you have, your intuitive ability to pick up is more. So I find good marketers able to do that quite well. That's my feeling. You should do it yourself as well. At least a few. At least a few.
Prem, now, okay, so you do these conversations or you're getting the secondhand data. Oh, there's a lot of stuff flowing in.
Yes.
How do you connect the dots? I think that is really the key here.
That is
how the do you key. Distill those three or four insights, which then go into the brief.
Yeah. So that's the tricky part. And maybe it's a bit of art, a lot of science and a bit of art, which comes from how do you join the dots? Which I also feel sometimes good creative people help you do. Sometimes you come back with three or four interesting consumer nuggets and you talk to creative people to understand, okay, but I have defined the problem clearly. That, for example, if I were to take Cadbury, and the success of Cadbury from say 95 to 2010-15 was based on a very simple strategy, substitute Indian meetha with chocolate. Kuch meetha ho jaye was the Cadbury line, which started with खाने वालों को खाने का बहाना चाहिए, साइरस बरूचा, देन दिवाली, देन यू हैव सीन सम अमिताभ बच्चन एडवर्टाइजिंग ऑन केनिया जीत गया, पालमपुर, देन यू डिड शुभारंभ, But the strategy was clear, which is, can you substitute culturally Indian Meetha moments with chocolate? That is the simple, now that's an Uber level. Source of business is Indian sweets. There is a cultural, lots of nuances. Exam ke pehle Meetha khake jao, which is Shubharam. Pehli tarikh jab pagar milti hai, log ghar mein chocolate leke aate hai, Meetha leke aate hai, that's another moment. Now you pick these. Now at some time you may get, okay, what we do is, there are many Meetha moments in India. And then you put the task. So when we started, we said, bada moment, shadi, celebration, Diwali pe pehle khelte hain. Then you said, abhi uska to saturation ho gaya, log khareed rahe hain abhi. And then you say, okay, let us now, maybe we have to own smaller moments. So we said, cricket match jeet gaya, pappu pass ho gaya. All of that came from smaller moments of victory pe chocolate ka kya role hai. So it is defined a bit by the objective and also then bringing the insights down to the what task we want to do. Then we go into something like Shubharam. But for example, when we did Pappu Pass Ho Gaya, Palampur, Kenya, which was Palampur is that cow wins in a competition and Kenya is India won a cricket, Kenya won some cricket match. The Uber objective was Cadbury was saying we are now growing well in metros, but small town India is still not behaving. So if you see that Amitabh Bachchan, that set of advertising, it has a slightly more earthy Indian feel. So you go to small town India to understand what are the insights that you can leverage. And then that, so it's joining the dot between the marketing objective, the communication objective, who is the consumer. So if I have to grow, I have to start increase my penetration in small town India as my marketing objective. Communication objective is what moments of Meetha in small town India can chocolate substitute. Now they may have come back from research and said, "Bhai, udhar small town India mein shaadi wadi mein koi chocolate nahi dene wala." But ye chota mota moments jo hai na, jo exam hai ya cricket match jeetta hai, that is a possibility. So that is then becomes the insight on which small moments of victory may be where chocolate can have a role in small town. I'm just saying hypothetically. So now I have joined marketing objective, communication objective, who is the consumer and the insight. And then the creative guy decides how he wants to cut it. So I may tell him, boss, small moments of victory mein, chota share mein, but then it's important for me to write consumer kone. To give him a picture of these are people who live in this small town, exam bada cheez hota hai, ya, you know, there are small victories that happen in them, they play games or sport or whatever that means. So that he has a picture kiske liye likh raha hai. That is basically a vision.
And then you'll need to also do the measurement, right? To figure out whether it's working.
Yes. Yes. Measurement happens at two levels normally with and depends again on the objective that you're setting. Some are brand type of measures. So for example, my awareness before the campaign was 63% of the people knew my brand. I set an objective saying, if I spend 40 crores in IPL, at the end of IPL, I want that 63 to become 67 or 68, for example. So that may be an overall awareness. I might say top of mind. When you think of batteries, you think of Exide, you don't think of Amaron. After this campaign, how many people thought of Amaron? Like, for example, now if I say Cred, all of you will shake your head. Because Cred was a nobody before IPL. After IPL, everybody remembered Cred. Now, what do they understand of Cred? I don't know, but Cred malum hai. So that's some measurable objectives on brand. People now even go to deeper measures, which is, I am aware, earlier I wouldn't consider you. So let's say you're a number four, say paint brand. Paint, you will say Asian Paints, naito Berger, naito Nerolac. You won't say Indigo. After the campaign, has Indigo gotten into the list? Is a consideration score. And then smart marketers like Indigo also have decided, okay, yeah, forget the room paint, I will own roof. And when people think paint, they may not think of me, but when they think of painting the roof or painting the floor, do they think of me as number one or two? So that those are brand measures. And then there is absolute sales, which is post 6 months, 1 year. Now the unfortunate part, and this is where this whole digital game begins, it's a bit of a jamela, which is, okay, the classic thinking, and I think it's true and it's not me, there's enough practitioners in the UK, IPA site you should check, International Practitioners of Advertising. See, brand building is long-term sales. It is not some happy. Okay, what we forget is, which they call in digital terms, there's a term that they use for it. It's called selective bias, which is my crib with some of the digital stuff. We don't know how much of it is bots. But apart from that, what they mean by selective bias is, Jaimit and I both were given coupons to sell garlic bread. Jaimit went and sold it near the traffic signal. I stood in front of Pizza Hut. Prem sold more coupons of garlic bread. Now we say, hey, Prem is a good salesman, Jaimit is a bad salesman. Do you know how many people whom Prem sold to would have anyway bought garlic bread? We don't know that. Now this is the, so what advertising does, the brand building does, is like, look at our own behavior when we go online. When you see a Nike, when you see a Fevicol, when you see an Asian Paints, you will look at that post. If I say Prem Narayan Paint Company, why will you look at it? So the top half of brand building is equally important to bottom half. Unfortunately, the brand building's link, and then there have been enough quotes like, you know, half the advertising spends are a waste. Unfortunately, I don't know which half and all of that is true. But, you know, we have become so quarter to quarter oriented, and that's the world, I don't deny it, that sometimes we think we don't measure over 2-3 years. If you measure the effect of great brand building over 2 years, 3 years, it gives you a far better picture than over 3 months. To put an advertising campaign, especially on big behavior shift categories like whatever, and expect people met the 2 mahina ad chalaya aur uske baad sab log abhi suddenly I will start paying my credit card bills through cred, I think is being a little, then there is a way, bribe the shit out of me, which then you have come to the bottom half of the funnel. Now, digital does a damn good job once you have interested me. Once I know that, once Prem is in the category and he's broadly looking for brands, then I don't need mass media. Then you can tag me, chase me, put me there. Like, I will give you an example of, you know, one day on my phone, I just went and clicked on some. There was a post which had Neiman shoes. I didn't know who it was. I just clicked on it. From then, they were so smart in the way they tagged me, which is what I think you would know well, Rajesh, Martech kind of stuff, right? I didn't bite it. Then they said, hey, maybe he didn't bite it because he didn't like the color. So they threw 4 colors at me. Then they said, it's the most comfortable shoe. I still didn't bite. Then they said something else. I still didn't bite. Finally, they said, hey, you know what? We are giving a festive offer now at 20% off. They followed me through in the way which provided I click first. My propensity to click online are to brands that I already love, have some affinity towards, which get built outside. I'm not saying only advertising. It may be physical presence, retail, it may be trust. Like, a certain generation of people may go and click online on an SBI post and not a private bank's post because that's the way they think. And so, yeah, so of course we do measure. So both are important. Justification, how a campaign is done well or not depends on what matrices you set before, both mind measures and sales.
So, Prem, I've been a, what I would say, what people would call a digital marketer for some time. And I want to argue that there is no such thing such as digital marketing. Hmm. There is marketing, and like you rightly said, digital sales. When you're looking at bottom of the funnel, you're looking at high intent, etc. When you're doing SEO, yes, sales hai. Ye aa raha hai aur ye bech raha hai. Marketing by itself encompasses a lot more. It talks about the personality, the purchase process, where all you can be, etc. And then getting all hyper about digital, which is exactly what you're rightly saying, the funnel at the end of the day. I would like to make these two distinctions and say digital sales hai. लेकिन ये ओवरऑल मार्केटिंग है. ईमेल भेजना डिजिटल सेल्स हुआ. ईमेल में क्या लिखना डिजिटल मार्केटिंग हुआ. सो दिस कंफ्यूजन इज व्हाट इवन आई हैव सीन. इज दैट व्हाट यू एको?
या सो सर्टेनली व्हाट यू आर सेइंग जैमित मेक्स सेंस. एंड आई थिंक वी विल कम टू अ वर्ल्ड हैविंग सेड ऑल ऑफ दिस वेयर कैन ब्रांड्स बी बिल्ड डिजिटली. ब्रांड बिल्डिंग ऑन डिजिटल आई थिंक इज पॉसिबल.
व्हिच इज फेयर.
And I think some iconic brands do it in India. I don't know how many have succeeded. Being Like for all the talk, tell me one Indian brand has got built itself to any scale only digitally in India. Few and far between. Very few. Meaning there are some people who say 100 crores, 500 crores and all of that. But tell me one big mass brand that's only built itself on digital. Very difficult. Unless it's a digitally native category. Then there is some chance. But even there, you look at it, Amazon, Swiggy, Figgy, all the, everybody is
doing TV and heavy TV.
Heavy TV, which then they fill the funnel down to this. The other point though, Jamin, that I feel is, I think we are not, as, and this is perhaps the older generation's baggage, or maybe we are not adapted. We are not thinking human behavior on that platform. We are still thinking what search words, this and that. And I'll give you a couple of examples that might illustrate. We did one campaign for an NGO who came to us with no money. It was at end acid sale, Reshma, acid attack victim. They had no money. They came to Ogilvy and said, "Kuch, can you do something for us? We have only money to put some maybe YouTube videos." Now, there was a beautiful learning out. It did very well. One can effectiveness, that lady, that girl who was went and walked on New York ramp, that NGO was able to collect money. People like Ashton Kutcher, all these fellows tweeted about it with zero paisa being, nothing was paid. I'll tell you what the insight was. It came from a very simple understanding that, okay, who are most likely, and they had a very simple make love, not scars, had an ambition of getting 25,000 people to sign a petition online. That is all their objective was. All this was happy benefits. To go to the Supreme Court and the High Court and say, please don't ban the sale of acid in open market. This was their thing. Now, we cracked a very simple thought. We said, who is likely to respond? We felt women will naturally be more supportive of this cause because they are the victims of this a lot. That was first level insight. The second most important insight was, nobody on earth searches for acid victim or acid sale. We said, what are women searching for on YouTube? They are searching for beauty tips. Lipstick kaise lagaun? So the campaign was called Beauty Tips. If you go to Google on YouTube now and say beauty tips make love not scars, it had this acid attack victim teaching people how to apply lipstick. So it was a very scarred visual, which made a point about how beauty mars, acid mars a young girl's beauty and destroys them. But that insight came from a very simple search behavior. For those of you interested, you should read a book called Everybody Lies, which actually is a guy that Google gave a lot of data to, meaning. And he talks about, you know, how in America today you can spot a virus infection faster. Google can predict it faster than anybody. But he basically uses search pattern and data to say things. Like he had given an example of Obama. And in fact, he got famous because he drew a map of America on the basis of the search word nigger. Nigger is a derogatory word used by white Americans when they think negatively of the African American. And he drew a map, and Trump won everywhere where the search word was more for nigger. And Google got interested in him and started using him. So he spoke about how Obama used data. Now, of course, I'm sure BJP and so many others use it. They've evolved to another level. But the example he gives, apparently Obama gave a long speech, Bhashan, about, you know, equality and treating African-Americans, Hispanics, Asians equally and all of that. Bada gyan. And he also threw in some 2-3 examples of people of these communities who are serving society. Feedback went to him that actually there was quite a lot of hate during his speech, but people also Googled this Mexican doctor, Asian fireman, or some other health worker. Now, the next time he spoke on the issue, he had 80% example and 20% gyan. Now that to me is smart brand building, which you find out how people are behaving. Like we did a campaign now recently with Cadbury, which had that geotag thing, or, you know, Purple Heart, where, you know, when people are trolling people, Facebook has an application. We said, put a purple heart to stop people from trolling. I think if we go a little beyond to understand human behavior on digital, I think we will have a lot more joy rather than just look at number and what search word, and that is there. It is important, but I think there is a layer below which we can understand.
So, Prem, what has kept you in planning all these years? I mean, the natural tendency would have been to either perhaps migrate to, say, the account side or the creative side. Planning is somewhere in between.
Yeah, so I'll tell you. Yeah, okay.
So, you know, besides ensuring that creatives have a hard time.
No, actually, creative guys like me.
So you think.
Perhaps why I've survived. Let me put it this way. I sometimes tell people that planning is actually the easiest job in enterprise. There is some truth to it. And my boss, Madhukar Sabnavis, who's our vice chairman, told me this when I joined Ogilvy, and I thought very valuable advice. And each person has a different personality. He said, think of this as a football field. The forward in advertising is always the creative guy. Who goal marta hai. Because he has to score the goal. That's the end product. Forget everything else. Forget the ego side and all. That's the product. People don't come to an advertising agency for slides. They come for work. The servicing guy is the defender. He has to guard against people's anger, make the money, shield everything, work on the relationship. And sometimes they are fantastic partners with clients, with planners, with creative people to get the best output out. He told me, your job is like a midfielder. You should be able to make the best. You try to make the best passes so that your creative guy is easy for him to score a goal. But remember, sometimes even when you make a lousy pass, he has to still score a goal. So be humble enough to know that. And you have to sometimes guard the goal with the defender, which is Jaimit, to your point. On jab client chillata hai, to planner aata hai, wo bhi sachche bhai, to main udhar hai. So I find, Raish, to your question, there are the Gangulis, there are the Tendulkars, and there are the Dravids. I was always a Dravid fan, and perhaps in personality times, I am closer to that mold. I am not so much in the, I have to score the goal mode. So that kept me, and beyond that, I really like what I do. I like meeting people. And in fact, I'm very poor at some of the account management skills. Like, I'm not a hunter. I can talk to you about business, but if you tell me now, you go and set up a 100 crore company, fat jayegi. Curd rice will start playing suddenly. So it's a mindset thing, meaning some people have the ability to take a punt and lead, and some people are great support. I've always seen myself as a better support person than a leader.
If I had to ask you, you know, which is like the one memorable campaign or the sort of, it was a planning victory. So where the midfielder basically managed to score the goal, you know, that is always the dream of a midfielder, I'm sure. Yeah. Because aaj maine goal kiya. What do you think it would be for you?
So for me, actually, the first campaign in Ogilvy, I think it also built planning's credibility, because till then we were seen more as slide people. Tata Safari, Reclaim Your Life, and then followed by that small shift in Pulsar, but that was a smaller one, but those were my initial ones. I think that gave me a lot of satisfaction. Then the work we did on Red Label, I think, made a significant difference to Unilever on teas. So those two, three, I would think are great. I think overall, not me personally, but Ogilvy, I think the whole Kuch Meeta strategy planning had quite a strong role in making Cadbury what it is, meaning literally increased per capita consumption of chocolates from 20, 30 grams a year to close to 150 grams now. I think credit of that is a lot. I mean, planning surely had a significant role to play. Of course, Piyush did iconic advertising on it and all of that. But those few, I would certainly, are some of the ones that I can think of. There are enough and more where creative, like Vodafone, purely built by creative people in the heydays of Hutch, Boy and Dog and all of that. Pure creative genius. Sometimes it's best to keep out of it. Some they do better work without us.
Yeah, I mean, what was the planning brief that a dog will follow you?
Oh, no, that's a very interesting story, Jaimit, because it's an interesting story because Vodafone had some very, Hutch had some very sharp marketeers, Asim Ghosh and all, who came, actually Pepsi people who came, and it was actually Orange, which became, actually Ogilvy had a history. We moved Max Touch to Orange, Orange to Hutch, Hutch to Vodafone, Vodafone to V. We've transitioned the same company 5 times. Actually, the story of the dog is interesting. Vodafone had a pillar called network, which was the fundamental. So they had network, service, value, and innovations. वैल्यू इज इरफान, महीने के पहले शेयर, महीने के एंड में चूहा, दैट एडवर्टाइजिंग, छोटा रिचार्ज, दैट वॉज वैल्यू. देन देर वॉज वैस जूजू विच वॉज इनोवेशन, एवरी न्यू थिंग वॉज इनोवेशन. नेटवर्क वॉज द फंडामेंटल ड्राइवर ऑफ द कैटेगरी, जिसका नेटवर्क अच्छा वो, बट नेटवर्क इज ऑल्सो पैरिटी. एयरटेल ऑल्सो यूज टू से नेटवर्क, वी ऑल्सो सेड नेटवर्क, रिलायंस वुड से नेटवर्क, एवरीबडी सेड नेटवर्क. दिस इज अ स्टोरी आई हैव हर्ड. सो व्हेन वी हैड टू टेल नेटवर्क, ऑरेंज एंड हच हैड अ ब्रांड टोन एंड मैनर विच इज द पर्सनैलिटी. एक्चुअली दैट ब्रांड, आई एस्क्ड योर क्वेश्चन, इज अ पर्सनैलिटी बिल्ट ब्रांड. सिंपली पुट, आई विल टेल यू हाउ पर्सनैलिटी इज फॉर एनी कॉमन मैन. इमेजिन कितने आदमी थे शोले वाला सीन, सीन वही है अभी. नाउ आई विल टेल यू डेविड धवन डायरेक्ट कर रहे हैं, आपको कुछ इमेज आया, कुछ हंसी मजाक जोक गोविंदा डिंचैक. अभी मैं बोला संजय लीला बंसाली डायरेक्ट किया तो वो गाना होएगा. अभी मैं करण जौहर बोला तो गब्बर स्विट्जरलैंड में, सामान सेम है. नाउ दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम थिंग. नेटवर्क इज द सेम, हाउ यू से बिकम्स अ बिग प्ले. Hutchin Vodafone had a tone which they used to in the complicated archetype, but they always believed in saying metaphors, simple human stories. We are childlike. While Vodafone is about, Airtel was about relationship and all of that. So they were trying to find a metaphor for, tere piche piche kon aata hai? Network tera piche, goes wherever, follows you wherever you go, was the thought. Then they said, kon hai wo? And originally for you, anecdotally, it was meant to be a elder brother and a younger sister. In the original script, there was no dog. Then one servicing person, who's now our vice chairman, Hepzibah Patak, told the creative guy, actually, yeah, maybe a dog may be an interesting idea. Because dog is even more unconditional. Sister at least will fight and go off, but a kutta to malik ko chhodta hi nahi hai. So the creative guys lapped it up and said, the dog can be a metaphor for the network to follow you. The dog originally was also supposed to be a Labrador, which misbehaved at the shoot and they found a pug. And then the rest is history. The pug, then India started buying pugs at 15,000 bucks and all. It was a happy coincidence. But these are some of the accidents that happen in advertising. But that's the story of the boy and dog and the network.
Big baat bol Prem. My my last one was, you said that creative guys like you. But ek baat bata, whenever you give a brief, okay, sometimes a brief is so beautifully tight, and I've seen some of the briefs that you've given. It's clearly emotion batata, ye batata. Situation bhi, in many ways, it is able to bring alive. Sometimes the brief is very, very tight. The creative job is either easy, yaar tune jo bol diya, wo bata diya, ya extremely difficult. Ki iske upar main kaise hai? Because you are actually tightening the guy.
Yeah, meaning it depends. I mean, so that's a not sometimes, like I said, I have given the ball in front of the goal post. So usko sirf paav dalne ka hai aur goal ho jayega. Kabhi kabhi bahut ganda maine miss goal bhi aisa kidhar to midfield mein phek diya aur bola bhai abhi tu jo karna hai kar. Wo kabhi bechara maar bhi deta hai. But to give you some examples, like let's take Safari for example. I drilled it down to, you know, Safari should stand for the angst and the rat race of corporate life and symbolize the life you want to live. Itna maine bol diya creative walon ko. And then I'd given them stories and other advertising that I thought would relate to. Like I'd given them a scene, if you remember Mr. and Mrs. Iyer, that movie, there is a sequence in that movie where Nandita Das is with Konkana Sen is with this guy. They're in a curfew and she's talking about and she's introduced him as her husband because of this Hindu-Muslim thing. And she, some girls ask them who are traveling with them, talk to me about your honeymoon. And they're cooking it up and he paints a picture of some log woods and jungles and music and wine and all. And after all that, she's almost like, actually, I should have married this guy and not the guy I really married. Now, that's the life that people... So I've thrown stimulus like this at the creative guys. And then one day, they refused to take this brief from me because they said, we've already cracked brilliant scripts on power. But one thing you should understand, the brief and briefing are two different things. Most people write the brief and then come back 1 week later and say, abhi tum kaam dikhao. good planners manage to have conversations going and they have a relationship. So one day they refused the brief, went back, and 2 days later this girl came and told me, who wrote that line, that I have a line and I think there's something here which says I always wanted to quit on a Monday morning. And then I said, yeah, it sounds interesting. And then they took it. Sometimes they play off stories. Sometimes the creative guys are left with very kacha thoughts that they have to build. But the most important thing, Jamit, is more storytelling, more consumer. Okay, three things that I think work with creative. Throw inspirational stories at them and don't say yehi karo. Creatives work off a brief, not to that one line. Oh, where is that main point? They may write something from something you wrote about the target audience, something you wrote in RTB mein se creative hai, like Amazon mein kisi ne nikala ki ye silver inside hai to jalega nahi, ek chicken foil mein daba ke khata hai to kidhar se bhi aa sakta hai. That is one. I think it's important to keep having conversations with creative people rather than say, okay, it's not like, okay, here is input, now give me output 1 week later. Never works like that. The good planners always find a way to strike the best conversation with creative people. And the most important thing that they want is people who can simplify. Now, we could have spoken all of this and more with very highfalutin, you know, the insight, and we're looking at changing the source of business from a loyalist to a infrequent user who uses it 3 out of 12 times. I think the trigger to shift the behavior is, aisa bro bolega to udhar hi wo band ho gaya sir. Now he'll say, "Arey, gyan dene aa gaya, ab chhod isko." But if you can tell him, "Bhai, ye mota mota problem hai," actually I think marketing is quite simple. So advertising to at least very simple. 3-4 चीज है, who is the consumer, क्या बोलना है, problem क्या है. It's simple meaning, it is only this which has lots of kitsch-pitch and nuances, but it is fundamentally, you can simplify. And I think the people who, creative people like, and I've even seen it as clients become more and more senior, they like people who simplify, not people who can complexify. More so in a digital world, because people are coming and asking, there is so much more. Now somebody is telling me there are 20 mediums. Should I be on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, this, that, and the other? Then there is data playing out, and then there is consumer insight, brand building. People are going berserk. They're saying, boss, somebody come and tell me, acha, ye char cheez karun main, bas, is that enough? Is there 2 things should I focus on? So I think simplifying is a very key planning job in today's time and age, much more than perhaps before.
So, Prem, one question. How you were one of the early planners in India.
In Ogilvy for sure, not Ogilvy. In India.
Now, how has it changed over the last 15 or 20 years that you have seen this firsthand? Obviously, what you just spoke about, you know, there's digital, there is so many more options and all of that. So the simplifier, of course, is even more important. But any broad things, and then, you know, linked with that is, are there significant more changes coming?
Yeah. Okay. 2-3 things that seem to be happening, I think, is one, I think planning as a function has grown by leaps and bounds in needs from clients. So just the fact that we were 3 people in 2004 and we are 65 today, and I always believe market and economy dictates who is required. So if we are all there, somebody is finding some value, I'm assuming. What has changed, I think, is more and more clients are seeking out. See, I think what's happened is most clients have a very good sense of their business. And they have a very good sense of their product. They have a very good sense of those things. But perhaps, and most clients tend to be a little more engineering-oriented, left-brained people. I think they seek the whole consumer understanding and the nuancing bit more and more, because how do you translate that into a consumer problem or a consumer opportunity? So I think they're seeking insights and all of that from planners. So planning has grown significantly because of that. Two, I think even internally, creative people are beginning to see more value in planning, because they're able to see that, okay, if I talk to this fellow something, at least he's giving me some intellectual simulation for me to work with. So those are 2 things that I see, which has not changed from then to now. It's become more because more and more clients want it. What has changed, of course, like you said, Rajesh, is that there is a lot of digital that has come into play. The understanding of one big shift is, unfortunately, advertising and media separated in the late 90s. I think that may come back. You know, today, like the medium is also the message. I won't say the medium is the message, but medium is also the message. Meaning how I talk on Insta is very different from how I'll talk on Twitter is very different from how I'll talk on YouTube. And understanding that well, I think is very critical. That's the shift. I think we are also surely moving towards a non-communication world of how you can improve consumer experience by understanding consumer behavior and touch points in their journey from offline to online, back to offline, back to online. And I think lots of people are wanting planners to come and tell them, like if I'm a paint brand, okay, I enter the store, I first search for something, then I went to the store, then I went to an experience center, then I went to a shade card. Don't ask me to start all of this from zero every time I'm going into every medium. Can you join the dots for me seamlessly? And what of those can be digital? What are offline? I think that, so from a communication lens to an experience design perspective through the journeys, I think where planning's needs will move as we move forward. And then of course, there is the data side. India's challenge is we have poor quality data, but I'm sure that will improve. Once data comes, people who are able to find patterns and interpret data will be the next level of King Kongs. Today we have data, but we don't know how to interpret them well enough. Like my cousin used to work in Shop Clues for a while, or one of those, he's a Yahoo guy. His job was to detect fraud. And he would look at large streams of data and say, like, you know, he found out a pin code from where there was lots of cash on delivery return. And when they actually, and so the data would spot towards, and when they went to find out why, they figured out it was a courier guy making money both ways by ordering and returning. Or like, you know, he was doing a project for, I think, Aditya Birla Group, and he used to get live data from shops. And he would say, Ghatkopar mein whites over index, so stock more. Or, you know, this shop sells more medium, less small, less large. Now, that level of data play, which I think clients will find stupendous value for, there'll be that side of data, but also data for communication and insighting. Is I think where it will go as we move forward. Some skills we have, some we don't have. We learn.
Yeah, I think it's been fascinating.
Thank you.
I have a much, much better understanding of planning. And I really think the way you've explained it, I think it's not just that the planning function should be in an agency. I think every business really needs a planner.
No, that'll be great.
Jamit, over to you.
Yeah. 1 hour goes with Prem Narayan talking stories after stories after stories. And I just am absolutely amazed every time I meet him. And I was just looking at some of the, trying to string together a lot of the hippo brains that we've had over a period of time. So starting from Anindya Ghosh, where he says about data, but he says, you know what, we need people with masters in philosophy, like what Prem is also talking about, the ability to look at it and form a coherent story, make sense out of it. It's very easy to get lost in that data, but lovely storytelling around it and the ability to look at it. And like Prem is saying, maybe you need some arts, cultural, language, linguistic background to be a great planner and not just a number MBA kind of a character. So Anindya spoke well about it. Sandeep Mittal, Hippo Brain spoke and put the layer for analytics and put the framework around it. Of course, we're going to have Rajesh Sardevan, who spoke about the storytelling art of it and Prem also talks about. Nehal from Hestia talks about how he just listens to the consumer and solves his basic problems. And that's why he's getting 4.8 stars on Amazon and on a cold press juicer. That's another fascinating story. Amul, we had Jain, and Prem, you spoke about how chocolate's working, and he's talking very clearly ki Amul wants to get into chocolates. And of course, Cadbury is the behemoth. How do I get in? I look after the bitter chocolate. Bitter chocolate does not even have milk. But I'm going there, driving a wedge to which now I can own some part of chocolate and start going in. And how you are talking about how Cadbury's is doing. And therefore, it's very interesting to understand how Amul is trying to fight through. And then we had Gautam Surat, who was talking about media and said, yes, sir, TK, but finally reach. And you have to reach there. And Prem, I loved your storytelling and the simplicity by which you explained advertising and marketing. And you're rightly saying, ki itna complicated hai hi nahi. Jao, suno, समझो, बोलो, बात करो. एंड द कोर पॉइंट, ब्रीफ इज नॉट इक्वल टू ब्रीफिंग. माई बिग वन, माई बिग टेक अवे. थैंक यू प्रेम, यू बीन अ ब्यूटिफुल होस्ट.
थैंक यू ऑलवेज.
Thanks a lot. And to our subscribers, this is fascinating. This is interesting. See how, what is the kind of range that we have on HypoBrain. Do subscribe, do press the bell icon. And thank you, Prem. And thank you all for being a great, brilliant audience. Thank you.